Hello students, looking at current affairs by 11th April, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these five. We'll look at them in detail. The first one, no evidence of community transmission. So yesterday we saw in news that ICMR study has said that there has been evidence of community transmission since March 22. But again, Union Health Ministry has denied evidence of community transmission of COVID-19 while reporting at least 700 new cases now. This is how cases have been increasing in the country. The highest single day spike yet was seen on Friday, yesterday. Then next is, this is regarding how states have been faring in with respect to COVID-19 cases, how cases have risen and number of deaths which have taken place. Kerala, which saw the COVID-19 in the initial days, increasing in the initial days, has seen only 2 deaths. UP has had 4 deaths. Maximum deaths have been in Maharashtra with 97. Then next is, scarcity of drugs, devices imminent, government warned. So countrywide shortage in medicines and medical devices is likely in the coming weeks is what Department of Pharmaceuticals has warned the Home Ministry. And it has urged it to take immediate steps to help drug makers resume production under the current lockdown. So though we have medicines, but further manufacture of medicines may be affected because medical device makers are functioning on an average of only 20-30% capacity during the lockdown. And half of India's output of pharmaceuticals is actually exported because global markets offer better prices. So we are also talking of providing hydrochloroquine to other countries. But then if our production is not resumed to full capacity, then it might be difficult. The present capacity is quite low. And the reason for this being because of lockdown. So because of lockdown, there is unavailability of labor, transport, courier services. These are the biggest problems, along with closure of ancillary industries, which the pharmaceutical industry is dependent on. So they are not considered essential by local administration and police, despite Home Ministry's direction. So here you can see reverse migration of labor has already taken place, which is having its consequences felt on pharmaceutical industry as well. And ancillary suppliers of inputs, which has been spoken of. These ancillary industries are because along with pharmaceutical drug manufacturing, also there's requirement of packaging material, excipients which are required for tablets and capsule manufacturing, utility consumables like gases, briquettes, grasses, which are required to run boilers in pharmaceutical industry, spare parts, etc. They are not available, so pharmaceutical industries are affected by that as well. So that is the problem. So here it's given how Indian pharmaceutical industry is also hit by restrictions imposed during lockdown, which will have adverse consequences. Then next is, India pounds LOC terror launch pads, Pakistan Army sites. So Army has said it has inflicted heavy damage on Pakistani Army's gun areas and terrorist launch pads after unprovoked ceasefire violation by the enemy side in 2 areas along the LOC in Jammu and Kashmir. Scores of villagers have been forced to shift their families to safer locations. These are villagers living along the LOC in Kupwara district in Jammu and Kashmir. Already they are suffering lockdown due to COVID-19 and now they are forced to shift because of the crossfire. Then next is, Saudi Russia wants oil cuts finalized at G20 talks. So top oil nations are finalizing a deal and they want it finalized at the G20 talks. So the 2 main countries which are involved here are Russia and Saudi Arabia, and they have agreed to lift prices which have already been fallen because of COVID-19 crisis. So they will take lion's shares and of the cut which is being proposed. So if output is cut, if there is supply restricted, then there will be increase in prices. More supply means less price. So that's what they are, it's a cartel. So they work together, it's oligopoly as you call it. A monopoly is one person dictating the market prices. So if it's a monopoly, you can demand any price and the product has, you are the only one supplying the product. And this OPEC is actually an oligopoly. It's a group of countries coming together and deciding prices. But then Russia is not member of OPEC. OPEC is Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. So Russia itself is not a member of OPEC, but there is an informal group called OPEC Plus in which Russia is also included along with other countries like Mexico as well. So in this OPEC Plus informal meeting, a pact to curb crude prices has been agreed on. So 10% cut will take place, 10% cut off global supplies, and a further 5% cut is also been proposed. But concluding of talks did not take place because Mexico refused to sign up in full. It does not want to take the cuts. So that was the problem. So this is a problem which is going on, and even US has pressurized Saudi Arabia that it has to make sure that oil prices do not rise, and it has to take action. Otherwise, US will impose sanctions on Saudi Arabia. So this is that. Then this is here, you can see OPEC membership shown. So OPEC countries are West Asian countries like Iraq, Iran, Kuwait, Saudi Arabia and UAE. That is it. Oman here is not a member of OPEC. Oman is a member of OPEC Plus. Light blue color shows OPEC Plus. So this you can see Oman is a member of OPEC Plus. This is here Malaysia shown. It's also a member of OPEC Plus. Then you have even Venezuela and Ecuador from South America, which are members of OPEC. And OPEC Plus membership is of Mexico, as we discussed. Then there are African countries also which are member of OPEC. So that is it. And major OPEC Plus members are here, you can see Russia and Mongolia. Then next is the last news. Removal of tariff ceilings may revive investment in renewables. So Center has decided to remove tariff ceilings for renewable energy tenders, and this will give the renewable energy industry a much needed leg up. So there were tariff ceilings at how much tariff can be charged per kilowatt of renewable energy. So the renewable energy has already been suffering because allocation rates fell from almost 75 to 80% which was seen in 2016-17 to 35 to 40% in 2018-19. And 2020 may see a further dip too, or it's expected to go down to 20%. So to give a leg up to the renewable energy sector, now government has decided to remove the tariff ceilings. Solar energy, the tariffs are presently, you can see, weighted average tariffs, they are in around 2.5 to 2.6 rupees per unit, so per kilowatt hour. And wind energy tariffs are at 2.8 rupees per unit. So, with tariff ceilings being removed, solar energy can have the sector has leeway to factor in higher risks in cases where counterparty have weaker profile or irradiance is low or there are other execution hurdles. So, this leeway has been given now to give a boost to the sector and create interest in the solar energy and wind energy and renewable energy sector in general. So, wind energy also faces execution challenges which will be now could be tackled. So here you can see the graph showing how tariffs have been falling in renewable energy sector. So you can see in 2012 solar energy was sold at 7.49 rupees per kilowatt hour per unit. So this has gone down to 2.44 in 2017. Even wind energy went down. And here you can see how renewable energy generation has dropped 20% in 2019. You can see this is how the renewable energy development dropped. Installed capacity has increased, however, but there has been a drop in renewable energy generation. And this is India's renewable energy target by 2022, which we have provided in the UN Paris Pact as such too under it. So these are our nationally determined contributions that we'll have renewable energy generated. So the segregation which is there for small hydro projects, biomass, wind and solar energy is given here. One change which has happened in recent years is that India has decided to have even hydro projects, not just small hydro projects, but all hydroelectricity projects as for constituting renewable energy. So that will give a huge boost to renewable energy generation in numbers. So this is there. You can see what the target originally was India will have 5 gigawatts of renewable energy through small hydel projects added up, 10 gigawatts from biomass, 60 gigawatts from wind energy and 100 gigawatts from solar energy, which is further segregated as 40 gigawatts through ultra mega power projects, 40 gigawatts from rooftop solar energy and 20 gigawatts from utility scale solar projects. So this comes up to total of 175 gigawatts of solar energy to be generated by 2022. Additional to be generated by 2022, which India agreed on in the Paris Climate Agreement. So that is it. Thank you.